Hello everyone, I'm Steve Tay. In this video, I'll show my work on my subject, Modern Web 2. I'm presenting a simple website that provides information in relation to food bank services in Hong Kong. Hong Kong, as an international city, it is a shame that we still have citizens in constant fear of hunger. So I want to create a website that points people to charity resources that gives out food for free. The piece of work is composed of two parts. On the server-side part, I'm implementing several services API that fully complies with the RESTful convention. So this is the window that I'm running the service. I'm listening at an 8080 port. And on the website, so-called client side, I use jQuery DynaJax to call this API from the actions. And behind Node.js, I use MySQL as a database backend to house information. So I will lead you to take a look on the database stuff. So I launch MySQL. I show. The databases. I'm using the food bank database, so I use food bank. And in the food bank database, I have two tables: the food bank table and the member table. So this is the content of food bank table. I have three records in here: the Chongqing Ministry, Food Angel Kitchen, and Feeding Hong Kong. So these three are real food bank services in Hong Kong. And I have another table called Member and for security login. So initially in this table, I have the user ID administrator and also the test user 01. And I'm going to create test user 02 in this process. Okay, on the website, the first function I provide is a list of all the food bank services. And for simplicity, I just list their names, but you get the idea. And you can display other informations too. And this page is for public access, so people do not need to log in. So anyone can access this page and get information from here. So this is the public part. And you can see the three records I have: Chongqing Ministries, Food Angels Kitchen, and Feeding Hong Kong. On this side, I have some log of the server running. So when I do things here, the program run and keep logs in the SSH terminal in here. I have this update function at food bank record in here. So this function requires some security control. If I just enter something in here and try to add a food bank, this page is for adding a new food bank record. So before I send the data through the RESTful API to my server, I display the JSON record, the information for you to take a look. And then I click OK. Then I receive a negative response. It's a bad request. How bad it is? It is bad since I have not logged in yet. So as a newcomer, I should first register as a member first. So I have provided this register as member function. The user ID I want to create is test user 02. The password is password 02, and email address email 02@skipter.com. And looking back at the database, you can see that this record is not there yet. And I'll try to create this record. So this is the information before I send to the API, and for the information I want to create, the member information I want to create. So I get a positive response saying account is being created. And if I take a look on the log, and I can see that I have some positive log in here. And if I search the table, you can see that the member table has test user 02 being created. So I have this new user, test user 02, I have the ID now. So now they can log in. So I provide this member login for people already having an ID. So if I just type in anything, test user 99, which just doesn't exist with any password, then I get this negative response, false 6, not acceptable because the user doesn't exist. So I need to log in with the right credential again. So this time I use test user 02 with password 02 and try to log in. So this is the information device sent to the API. And this time I get positive response saying login is successful. So with a successful login this time, I expect I can add the food bank record now. So I add food bank record. So I want to create a food bank record with ID DDD. The name is DDD Chongqing Ministry. Another one. And address is DDD something. And services is DDD food hall. And I can create a Google Map link, and so this is HTTP something, Google something. So I try to add this record, add to food bank. So these are the information I try to send to the API, and I get positive response that the food bank record has been added. I look at my log and I see that the record is being created. And if I check my database now, I can see that the DDD record is being created. So I have this ability to add record now, but I have also done a little work on mashing up API with Google Map. So this time I want to create another food bank called Food Angel Hong Kong. But I do not exactly know their address, so I try to use the get button to get a suggested address from Google Map. So I say Food Angel Hong Kong. So when I click this get, and instead of adding the food bank record right away, I'm calling the Google Map API, Google API, and to search for information relating to Food Angel Hong Kong. And Google API return positive information. With this information, there's a string of information relating to this Food Angel Hong Kong. Then I retrieve related information like address and a Google Map link from Google API. This Google Map link is the concept is for people to search or directly link to a Google Map location. The concept is that, of course, it can be fine to pinpoint the place and everything, but you get the idea. So what I need to do now is to assign another ID to it. I call it EEE, and I modify the name a little, and update information of the services it provides, like this Food Angel Hong Kong, they do food waste rescue, and they prepare and deliver meal meal boxes, and they open a food hall. So these are the information. I can add another record. All this information and for the RESTful API to create, and another record being added. So with the help of Google API, I mash up the content on the client side and build the information and send it to the host. And the host got update successfully. And I checked the database. I have the EEE record also. This is what I do. Simple it is, but it illustrates several things that we are capable of using Node.js and implementing RESTful API with persistence data being updated to a database behind, and an ability to mesh up and the use of other services API in the application to achieve a better result. So this is it. Thank you very much for watching.